The Caribbean is currently host to 12 active volcanoes, although there is a peculiarity among them, as there almost seems to be some form of threshold that blocks any eruption from erupting more than 1 cubic kilometer of tephra at least during the last 9,000 years. During this time span, more than 100 volcanic eruptions have occurred across the Caribbean, of which 29 were VEI-4, meaning they erupted between 0.1 and 0.99 cubic kilometers of tephra, such as witnessed during the 1902 eruption of Pele. While a VEI-4 eruption is still quite large, the lack of recent larger-scale eruptions can be attributed to the lack of higher silica content lavas which have erupted during this time period, largely being composed out of only basaltic andesite and andesite rather than dacite. Yet, if you look around the volcano on the island of Dominica, which produced the Caribbean's last VEI-5 eruption, Morne Trace Pitons, you will find some unusually thick deposits comprised of pyroclastic flows and ashfall. These are well exposed at a quarry where one unit towers to an impressive 19 meters or 62.3 feet thick. This incredibly thick rock unit is referred to as the Erosio Tuff and formed in a series of eruptions, one of which was the Caribbean's largest single explosive eruption in the last 1 million years. The largest of these was not a VEI-4 or even a VEI-5, but a mid-end VEI-6, representing an eruption that ejected 58 cubic kilometers of tephra, being 20.1% larger than the 1883 caldera-forming eruption of Krakatoa in Indonesia. This eruption also formed a caldera, although it has been largely hidden due to the high rate of the region's erosion. Known as the Wotten Waven Caldera, it measures 7.3 kilometers long and 3.4 kilometers wide. Sections of its caldera wall are still visible, most notably where it cuts across the section of the Mekotrin lava dome and at a raised ridge on the caldera's western edge. With caldera walls as much as 300 meters or 984 feet in height, it is hard to imagine the sheer scale of this ancient eruption. But with the aid of science, we can reconstruct what this ancient eruption may have looked like, with the eruption having a composition ranging from high silica andesite to low silica dacite. Approximately 33,342 years ago, a large body of high gas magma, likely totaling approximately 24 cubic kilometers of molten rock, had built up underneath a patch of ground 5 kilometers or 3.1 miles south of the largest of the lava domes in the Trace Pitons volcano. Hot springs likely existed above this patch of ground, and occasional fumaroles dotted the landscape. But as the days progressed, the number of earthquakes continued to increase, involving several magnitude 5 quakes. Volcanic tremor eventually began until the ground began to be pushed upwards by more than a meter, caused by the movement of this magma towards the surface. Finally reaching the surface, a powerful explosion occurred, blasting out a more than 200 meter wide crater and sending a plume of ash 35 kilometers or 115,000 feet into the atmosphere. More explosions occurred along a north-northeast trending chain as lava erupted onto the surface from a several kilometer long fissure. As part of the eruption column collapsed back to the ground, it generated 500 degrees Celsius pyroclastic flows that raced across the landscape, scorching all vegetation over an area of land totaling 212 square kilometers, reaching patches of land up to 14 kilometers distant. Entering the water, two medium-sized tsunamis were generated by displacement, affecting Dominica and several neighboring Caribbean islands. After the pyroclastic flows entered the water, they continued as density currents on the ocean floor, traveling up to 22 kilometers away. Over the next 50 hours, the prevailing winds blew to the west, causing significant amounts of ash to fall, totaling more than 5 meters thick next to the erupting vent, while causing Guadalupe, Martinique, St. Vincent, Montserrat, and Dominica to receive more than a centimeter thick of ash. Then, due to the large amount of erupted material, the overlying rock collapsed downwards to fill the empty space in the underlying magma chamber, forming the Wotten Waven Caldera. This same caldera would go on to produce three more VEI-5 eruptions over the next 8,000 years until 25,000 years ago, and has since only produced small volume lava flows. As a final note, I would like to thank Linda E. Dewey, MD, for increasing their Patreon membership tier to this channel.